Thanks. I have a deep love for business and success, and they're my goals now. And I've had businesses where I've had to do the collection and collect money from people, and I was successful with that. But since then, I've found another business, which is private investing, which to me is the purest of businesses because it's only me, and the reward is instant. And so I'm doing that, and I have been successful with that. But it's kind of like that Jerry Garcia song, "Some days the light's just shining on me. Other days I can barely see." And now I'm at the barely see point. And I've created the best instructors for my business, and which I always do whenever I want to learn something. I always have the best come to me. So I have all the principles lined up for this business. And I know deep in my heart to succeed in it. But now I'm kind of like, you know, I've been that bird soaring up there in the blue sky, and I can see everything below me that is endless. But now all of a sudden I found myself trapped in a house, and there's a lot of windows, and I'm that bird just hitting that window. I can see the blue sky, and I can see I can soar out there again. But it's like that invisible shield is
there.
Well,
now you want to pay attention to the analogies that you're offering, because mm-hmm. are the analogies that you're offering soothing you or antagonizing you? In other words, when you draw the image of a bird
yeah.
in a glass house that wants out.
That's the way I'm feeling now. And it's
well,
like,
we know it's the way yeah. you're feeling, but it's not the way you want to feel. And
no.
And the thing that we can hear from you is it sounds as if that what you're feeling, and everyone certainly understands this, and the Jerry Garcia song was about this, and the way you interpreted it is, mm-hmm. when I make good choices, my heart sings and my world is bright and beautiful. Mm-hmm. And when I make bad choices, then I feel awful, and so my happiness depends upon me always making the right choice. Mm-hmm. Or my happiness depends on the market, or on someone's advice, or on my choice paying off. My happiness depends on this action. And we want to help you to understand that your happiness depends upon the thoughts that you choose that produce the emotion. Now, certainly we understand that emotions can be tied to behavior, mm-hmm. or emotions can be tied to outcome. Our friend talked about that when somebody said something to her, it hurt her feelings. And so it was as if her emotions or her happiness were tied to somebody else's opinion. And you sound like your happiness is tied to the outcome of the investment
success.
That you make
yeah.
or the success that you make. And we want you to today begin making the decision that you are going to take an emotional journey rather than an action journey. And the greatest success that you are seeking is the success of alignment with who you are. That is ultimate success. Moment by moment, aligning with who you are, that's success. And every other success will follow. When you've decided to take the emotional journey, and we're going to demonstrate this in a powerful way in just a moment. When you decide to make an emotional journey, which you can accomplish in 1 to 5 to 15 minutes easily every time, no matter where you are. When you decide that you're going to reach for the success of an emotional journey rather than needing to wait for the market to turn around or for your investment to pay off before you award yourself the label of having succeeded, mm-hmm. then you can be successful constantly. When you have decided to reach for the success of alignment, which is indicated by how good you feel, when you've decided to reach for the success of alignment, now you're on your way to the success of clarity, the success of financial reward, the success of physical well-being, the success of fabulous relationships. In other words, every success that you are reaching for is intimately tied to your understanding of the success that you must reach for first, which is the success of achieving vibrational alignment with the energy of your source, which we've already discussed and discovered here today, which is also in alignment with your very desire.
Uh-huh.
The analogy that we like best is Jerry and Esther driving from Phoenix over to San Diego. They're on their way to San Diego. Halfway is Yuma, Arizona, when they find themselves in Yuma, they don't get so discouraged that they're not yet in San Diego that they get disoriented and go back to Phoenix. In other words, because that journey is understandable. They know they're headed west, and they know that if they maintain a reasonable course and a reasonable speed, that they're going to have the success of being where they are going. And so what we are wanting you to realize is that so often in trying to achieve success, whether it's financially or whether it's in a relationship or whether it's with something with your body, that the action journey is not quantifiable like that driving across the desert journey is that we've just described. In other words, very often you start off in the right vibrational direction, but then because it hasn't manifested instantly, you stop and take score and you discover that you haven't achieved the success that you're looking for, and then you freak out and have that rainy day that you've described, decide that you're a bird inside of a glass house and you can't get out. And now you sort of freak out and you turn around and you go in the opposite direction. When you were headed in the right direction, you just gave up too soon. You just took score too soon. So the physical action journey that our physical friends so often want to take goes like this. Well, I want to make the right investment, which means I want to get the right intuition, which means I want to get in touch with myself so that I can always read my guidance, which means, and I want to get the right tip, and I want to be in the right place, and I want to have the right money, which means I've got to save up for it. And so it's this long, convoluted, sometimes impossible to even fathom journey to get to the successful place that you're looking for. If someone's looking for success in a physical condition when they're sick, the success might be, well, I've got to find the right specialist, and I've got to find the right HMO or insurance plan that will pay for it, and I've got to find the right way to get released from my job long enough that I can have the treatment, and I've got, and all this long, convoluted journey of to get from sickness to wellness, sometimes they can't even see a possible path, and so they don't allow it to come. Where the emotional journey is much simpler. The emotional journey is, I want to release my fear of this sickness and replace it with the hope of wellness. An emotional journey from fear to hope is just a matter of talking the fear down and talking the hope up. And you can do that if you try a little bit and if you're willing to leave your negative analogies someplace else. And so in some ways, you've actually been taking a reverse emotional journey. You've been taking a situation that's not that bad and telling yourself sad stories that make you feel worse.
It's deadly.
This was powerful, isn't it?
Yeah.
In other words,
I'm
going to take an emotional journey. And are you getting it that when you take an emotional journey, that means when I take myself from an emotion that doesn't feel so good to emotion that feels a little better, what's actually happened is you've released resistance. The emotional journey means raising vibration. The emotional journey means achieving more vibrational alignment with what I want and achieving less vibrational alignment with what I don't want. So you don't have to be afraid of those thoughts. In other words, you're just working to achieve vibrational alignment with the thoughts that feel better. So then when you realize that it's just a matter of shifting your vibration, and when you've shifted your vibration, you've shifted your point of attraction, and when you've shifted your point of attraction, then all kinds of things are going to flow to you. New inspiration's going to come. You're going to get an idea about something. You see, what most people do, even in a situation like you are, or someone who wants to win the lottery, or someone who wants to go to the slot machine and choose the right one, what they often think is, all right, I'm going to use my guidance system, and my guidance system is going to lead me right to the winning machine. And we say, still, you're approaching it in the same way that you've approached it. You might as well be approaching it with action. It's like, I'm going to walk myself over and I'm going to possess something and I'm going to capture it and bring it back for my success. What creation is about is changing the vibrational nucleus right here where I am, so I begin to allow myself the reception of the stuff that already is trying to get in. We would love it, and here we're going to turn your bird analogy around in a way that is very positive and will feel very good to you. So picture yourself in that glass house, and picture all the success that you've been wanting, like birds trying to fly into the house. And picture your resistance, the glass that is keeping it from flying in and surrounding you, you see. So now see yourself in that house just relaxing and letting the resistance melt away. Success is coming to you. You're not out there trying to go get it. Success is coming to you. Wellness is coming to you. Clarity, money, abundance of all nature. It's flowing to you. You've already asked for it. The universe is already in sync with it. The universe is in alignment with the idea of you having it. The universe is flowing it to you in endless ways. Your work is to relax and let it in, relax and let it in, relax and let it in. Mm-hmm. We just gave you the basis of everything that is. That's what evolution is. Contrast causes the new desire, and the key to a happy life is not getting too much separation between the desire that I'm launching and the expectation that I'm finding.
Of getting there.
Yes. What happens to most people is they talk about the good times, and they talk about the bad times, and they talk about the good times, and they talk about the bad times, so they've got both active in their vibration. And then somebody comes along that's having an experience, and they're easily activated either way. It could go either way. Uh-huh. And then they have the experience. And what it really is sloppy vibrating, sloppy thinking. What it is, it's vibrating all over the place with no central theme, no real understanding of what the success is that I'm really looking for.
Uh-huh.
Because I'm using that guy and what he thinks is my guidance, and then that guy and what he thinks is my guidance, rather than what is coming forth from within me that gives me consistent guidance, you see.
Uh-huh.
In time, as you stand back and get a look at those around you, you realize that there are people who have very little financially that are really in alignment with what they want, and they're having perfect success. That's why we have always said, as long as Esther has allowed us to flow words through her mechanism, the success that you're reaching for, the trophy you're looking for, is the trophy of joy. Nothing else matters. Mm-hmm. And when that is the trophy of success that you're looking for, then everything else that you regard as success must be yours.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes.
I will lighten up. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Well, we've answered everything. What are you doing with your hands in the air? Right here, then here.